world-class fighter, but this was his first 10-rounder. Up against Steve Chinnock, 8 wins out of 8 so far. Been learning and developing quietly, this boy, but we'd now find out a great deal more. British title eliminator, then.
British featherweight scene split into two halves, really. Scott Harrison emerging as a world-class fighter. Nassim Hammad, should he come back again, we know is one of the elite. And Michael Brody remains determined to be part of that category. Then there's the domestic level fighters, and two here hoping to stake their claim. Dazzo Williams just bundled to the floor, and the black trunks of the long-rangey Steve Chinnock. Both have gone about their careers quietly, haven't done too much wrong yet, but they need exposure, and quickly.
Yeah, well, Williams at 29 and Chinnock at 27, they don't really have too much time to hang around, so this chance has come maybe just at the right time for both of them. Early days in their careers, but at 29 and 27, time to get moving.
Chinnock, who is the Midlands 9-stone champion, has the skills, can box. Williams, you feel, has the edge in aggression, possibly power.
He
was the better amateur. Just trying to get control early, Williams. But it's how he deals with the long arms of Chinnock, isn't it?
Yeah, but I think he'll be glad when the fight reaches the fourth and fifth rounds, it gets a little bit closer. He'll probably have problems for a couple of rounds, just pinning Chinnock down.
Good right hand from Dazzo Williams. Looked really impressive last time out in March at York Hall when he beat Mark Callahan in a mini thriller over 8 rounds. Really good one, wasn't it?
Yeah, but and his condition really impressed me that night. The pace he set all the way through, never stopped working. And I thought then that maybe it could be a straight crack at the British title. But this is him a step along the way.
Trying to get his own right hand in there, Steve Chinnock. But it's Williams who's made the more positive start. Seems a real hunger about the man, formerly from London, who lives in Hereford. I was speaking to him at York Hall. He said he really wanted a crack at the British title, that Steve Robinson has really lit up his career. It was low from Chinnock as they trade at the end of the first. Third round in the bustling British featherweight division. The tall, long, rangy Steve Chinnock, born in Lichfield from Rugeley, where he boxed at his local amateur club. Did pretty well in the unpaid ranks and has never lost as a professional. But he's never been in with someone like Dazzo Williams. How will he handle it? Strong physically, Williams is. Again, works the body, doubling up with those left hooks. Is that the right shot with somebody so tall as Steve Chinnock?
Yeah, but I think that the main thing is to keep the pressure on. I mean, Chinnock is really becoming ragged. He's having to fire back just to survive here. It's not the way he likes to box. He's been forced into doing that. And I think the fitness of Williams is going to be a big plus if this fight does go into the middle and later stages. I sometimes wonder, can Chinnock cope with the strain and the punches of Williams?
Scheduled for 10, and Chinnock has been that distance when he won the Midlands title over Kevin Gorowski of Nottingham. being forced to trade, and he looks open to those left hands. Gumshield comes out, first distress signal from Steve Chinnock, looks at his corner and wants a respite. Looks tired already, doesn't he?
Yes, because he's under pressure all the while here. He's not being allowed to use the ring. I think the only chance of victory is to use the ring. Nice little bit of smart boxing, but Williams is not standing for that. Just keeping him under the cosh here all the while.
Real grimace on the face of Steve Chinnock as he clenches that gum shield in. How confident, almost arrogant, Williams looks. They never met in the amateurs. I think Williams always felt he had the edge there and that he was the better man. So far, that has proven to be the case as they meet in the professional ranks.
Not so much coming from Williams in this little spell here.
It's better from Chinnock. He'll give him a little confidence, getting him with that right hand. Needs to fiddle Williams about, mess him around, try and get some of his own skills working.
Yeah, he's got to try and use the ring, but it's not easy when the other fellow is able to walk you down, just come through your punches. That's his big problem. He needs a little bit more snap in his punches to discourage Williams. He doesn't seem to have that.
10th professional outing for Hereford's Dazzo Williams, and it's going well. Looking for win number 8, and the one that will launch him towards a shot at the British title. What can Steve Chinnock, this long, tall, awkward Staffordshire fighter, do now? He's never tasted defeat before. Will that give him the edge should it go long? Or is too much damage being done already?
See, his big problem, man, he doesn't have enough snap in his punches to keep Williams away. So when the other fella can walk through what you've got, there's not much else that he can do. That was better.
He's only got 2 stoppages on the record, Chinnock. Williams, 3. But probably a bigger puncher than the stats suggest. It upset Mickey Coveney and the hot commentary prospect at the time, Mark Payne, who'd won 12 in a row. That was at the start of the Williams career. Derailed slightly, but at the moment back on track. Just a little mark under the right eye now of Williams. Chinnock just gets his range a touch better. That was a good uppercut.
I think the main problem, or the only problem for Williams, he's walking forward, but he's not really letting many punches go in this round. You still have to land punches to win rounds. And so far, Chinnock might just be nicking this one.
Roundhouse right from Williams. Swelling under both eyes now for Dazzo Williams, and just that little blemish under the left eye of Chinnock. Does he need more head movement, Williams, at this point?
He needs to do more work. I mean, he's just stalking. And in this round, he's stalking as opposed to pressurising. Really, he should be letting bursts of punches go as he was doing in the first couple of rounds. So he's like a stalker here, but not letting the punches go. And Chinnock is nicking this round.
Better boxing on the back foot from Steve Chinnock, to the delight of his corner. But again, the left hook comes in from Williams.
I would have thought the longer the fight was going, the more Williams would be taking over. But his form has just dipped a little bit in this round.
What a brighter spell at last for Steve Stumpy Chinnock. What a strange nickname, seeing as he's one of the tallest featherweights we have. Is better, and his fans certainly enjoying it. second half of this British nine-stone title eliminator. It's the 29-year-old Dazzo Williams in the white trunks against the black colours of the 27-year-old Steve Chinnock. That's how Jim has it. Williams dominating early, but Chinnock having a nice fifth. What happens now?
There's just been one for pushing down, just a couple of little survival tactics there, because I think Dazzo Williams is trying to raise the pace again and to get himself back into the driving seat.
Searching for the uppercuts. Gumshield just comes loose again from Steve Chinnock. Never really got settled. He's slipped on the advertising hoarding. He's had to take a slight rest after Williams hit on the break from a body shot. The mental advantage is going to Williams at the moment.
Oh, that was well low. Yep, he's been one to keep them up. No complaint from Chinnock, which was nice. Come on.
And Williams accepted it as well, put his glove up. Good respect between these two. And the fairly decent amateurs. Midlands titles won by Chinnock. ABA by Williams. Will that just be the difference here? Good right hand, beautifully switched from Dazzo Williams. Got a bit of class about him at times, hasn't he?
Yeah, well, he's showing a little bit of technique in this round, whereas before he was just kind of trundling forward, letting the punches go, but we're seeing some nice technique then. A little bit more imagination. This is a better round there for Williams now.
Switch hitting, getting back into his groove. Looking for the uppercuts on the inside, as well as the body shots. Variety from Dazzo Williams. And better work rate.
Yeah, well, that's what was lacking in the previous round, previous couple of rounds, actually. I wonder if he's had a little lecture in the corner.
Oh, Chinnock just looked hurt by that. Just had to take a few steps back. Tries to sink his boot into the canvas to get, and he has to take a count, I think. He does, he goes down, Steve Chinnock. He was hurt about 20 seconds ago by a couple of body shots. And Dazzo Williams bouncing on his feet and ready to keep up the pace. Big breakthrough.
Yeah, Chinnock just seemed to sag there along the ropes. Managed to keep his feet, but totally winded, and he's looking as though maybe it's time to get him out of here.
Hey, come on. Hey, gotta be together again. You're gonna bang away at the body. Do this. Come on. Slow it down. Now, come on. Hey. Come on. I think you want to come out. Look at me. Look at me. I think you want to come out. Well, if you don't do anything this year, I know it'll look for you now. Okay. Hey, come on. Okay. Because you're only gonna survive.
Fascinating insight from the corner there of Steve Chinnock. Len Woodall says, you've got a round, do you want this? I don't think so, and Errol Johnson will pull you out if you don't do anything. Right advice?
Yeah, well, you can see the look on his face as he went back. I mean, that was a signal that the body shot just took everything he had left out of him. But maybe they're trying to pull him back together again, but it's sensible corner work. If a kid has had enough, then get him out of there. This will be his last round if he doesn't have some success here.
Very, very slow and lethargic to come out of the corner, Steve Chinnock. He's been given 3 minutes by his team, and Dazzo Williams goes back relentlessly to work. He's really enjoying it, this is Steve Chinnock facing his first professional defeat.
Well, heading out for this round, he needed
blood coming from Chinnock's nose, but look at this bravery. Badly damaged nose of Steve Chinnock. Williams badly hurt, having had Chinnock down in the previous round, and this title eliminator is really hotting up.
Well, we're seeing that Chinnock lacked the power to discourage Williams. Well, he certainly found it with that shot.
Oh, punches bouncing off each other. It's now going down to the trenches, and who wants it more? And who would have thought that after Steve Chinnock went so wearily back to the corner at the end of the sixth?
Well, this business never ceases to surprise you, but I never thought I would see Williams on the floor. Unbelievable.
Right eye looking worse. A lump over it now for Dazzo Williams. He did look hurt when he went down, didn't he?
Well, I thought at first when he went down that it was eye damage. I thought maybe the edge of the glove had caught him in the eyeball. But when he got back up, he seemed a little bit shaky, and he was under pressure from Chinnock, so obviously the punch did shake him.
To the nose of Chinnock now. Trying to spur Williams on, just bundle each other over. He still looks exhausted, Steve Chinnock. He's given absolutely everything into this round. What guts and courage as he takes a heavy right.
He actually looks drained, Adam. Chinnock does not look as though he has much left. He really wants to hear this bell, and there it is.
Well, well, well. The hardest fight of each other's career, and that's what's happening. Exciting stuff.
Yeah, well, that was a shock. I mean, I didn't think Chinnock had the power to hurt Williams. Williams was having all his own way. He was the powerful guy. When he went down here, I thought it was trouble with the eye. I thought maybe the cup of the glove or the thumb had gone in his eye. He seemed to be in more distress than actually hurt. See the punch here, and the reaction, it's not as though he was badly shaken, it's as though something's happened. You can see him holding his eye, then going down to get away from the follow-up punches, but you can see him rubbing his eye here. So I thought at this point he's not really hurt, but when he got back up again, he was under real pressure. But he certainly come back well towards the end of the round. I think at this point you can see Chinnock is almost drained. Can he find something to come out with at this round?
Steve Chinnock found an uppercut that proved to Len Woodall and Errol Johnson that he should still be in this fight, and now they're spurring him on. Both men have been down. Chinnock looks the more jaded. Williams has more eye damage. Three rounds to go, and remember, the man from Hereford has never been beyond eight. Nose looks broken of Chinnock, doesn't it?
Yep, and that's obviously if he's breathing with his mouth open, that's going to give him more problems.
Well, since he turned professional in September 2000 with a fifth round knockout of Neil Reed, Steve Chinnock has come up on the undercards on the small dinner circuit scenes. This has been the first real test. At the moment, he's still in there. But Jim, surely he's way behind on the card.
Yeah, well, the knockdown round was certainly tightened things up, and had already scored the previous round to him. But he's struggling again. I think that little bit extra strength is proving crucial that Williams has.
Just never really been able to keep Dazzo Williams off him, at bay, and in any way control this fight. It's the sheer persistence and come-forward style of Dazzo Williams. and the odd clever shot like that. Is he just more rounded, Williams?
Yeah, but I just think he's naturally stronger, a bit more mature, just natural strength. And you can't fault Chinnock's fitness or his heart, his courage. He just doesn't have the physical strength. And where they found the power for that knockdown punch, I don't know. Because they didn't show anything of that in the first half of the fight.
One of those miracle punches that's kept him in the fight. Must be a real struggle for him doing 9 stone at 5'10" as well. Remember, Scott Harrison's about 5'7", Nassim Hamad 5'3". Really is long-bodied. And that's been taken a peppering tonight by the wicked left hooks of Dazzo Williams. The weary warrior returns to the... Just 2 rounds to go then of this British featherweight title eliminator. The black boots and black trunks of stumpy Steve Chinnock from Rugeley, who at the moment could be facing professional defeat number one. But remember, he had Dazzo Williams on the floor and backed him up with punches following that. Can he grind out another spell that will give him some hope? Is there enough strength left? It's a little mark by the left ear as well of Dazzo Williams. They're both going to feel it in the morning, aren't they?
Yeah, this is a real grueling one for both of them, particularly along the young Chinnock. But doing well, and still, I mean, Williams is obviously feeling the pace too, because his work rate has dropped fairly drastically. Yep, nice little burst from Chinnock.
Look at the red marks on the back and sides of Steve Chinnock. Almost looks as though he's been out in the sun too long. Good jabs from Dazzo Williams. Still looks strong and tenacious.
Yeah, but a lot of these shots are missing the target in this round.
Jammed him there, Chinnock. That's what the corner want him to do. Box and box. But is there enough time left? Has he left it too late?
See, Williams is still walking forward, but not really letting any punches go, not pressurizing the way he was earlier.
It's a better left hand, though, as the gloves came down of Chinnock. The aggressor against the boxer, and once again Williams just has that added quality to land the punches. And now Chinnock's work rate's gone down. They give each other a knowing look at the end of a pretty level night. And what now? A knockout for Chinnock?
Yeah, that's what he needs. That would be the second shock of the night. The knockdown was definitely a shock. You can hear what they're saying here. See, Williams still forcing the pace. Like, that was a nice little burst of punching, but I don't think we saw enough of that in the ninth round. Still looking for the body, but Chinnock's tightened up down there, keeping that elbow nice and tight there. I think he's had as many body shots tonight as he wants.
Three, we're on a bad word right now.
Come on, son, come on. Three needs to go. Come on.
Well, they're trying to work wonders in there, Errol Johnson and Len Woodall. But the truth is, Steve Chinnock has 3 minutes left to save this. Dazzo Williams dominated the first four or five. He was down in the seventh, Chinnock in the sixth, and Jim, on your card, Williams four ahead.
Yep, well, on my card, obviously, Chinnock looking for the knockout, and as I say, that would be shot number two.
At the end of the sixth, he was given a round by his corner. He found an uppercut. Can he find another one? A hard-fought, grueling, very determined little featherweight battle. It's been a pleasure to commentate on, hasn't it?
Yeah, there's never been a dull moment, and we've had quite a few more rounds than I expected. Around about the halfway stage, I thought young Chinnock was on the way out, but he's shown great determination and grit to get himself back into this.
Key probably is that Dazzo Williams has just been allowed to do what he does best more of the time, and Steve Chinnock's boxing has been in fits and starts, but never really for long enough. But how he's still going, I'll never know.
I think too often in the fight he was really in survival mode, because if he's been out of strength and out work. But every credit, deserves every credit for the show he's put up tonight.
Steve Robinson's been really cool and calm in the blue corner. Errol Johnson and Len Woodall very animated in the red one. They've done everything they can to get Steve Chinnock through it, but it's down to him. It's down to the boxer himself, who has weathered the storm and those right hands and left hooks.
He just has to grit his teeth now, because his defences are gone. He's been caught with a long-range shot. It's Chinnock just wants to hear that final bell. He's exhausted.
How much leather's been thrown in there in 10 really good rounds of featherweight action. They may not be the best, they may never be the best, these two, but they have put their all into this contest. Di Gardner and Steve Robinson beckoning Williams to finish strongly, but surely he's done enough. Surely he will inflict the first defeat of Steve Chinnock's professional career. It's up to Paul Thomas. He does. Dazzo Williams goes forward, but Steve Chinnock can go back to Rugeley with his head held very, very high.
Yeah, well, the people in the fight game, we always totally respect courage, and this little fella showed that in bucket loads tonight. I wouldn't say it was Williams' best performance. Set a good pace all the way through, a little bit more imagination here and there would have come in handy, but nevertheless, an important victory.
700 punches thrown between them. You see the success rate though, nearly double for Williams. That the difference. He just ground down Steve Chinnock, but he couldn't stop him. The Staffordshire man still on his feet, but well, they're both going to be totally shattered tonight and deserve a good rest. Decent fight. Well done to the pair of them.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Paul Thomas has requested you show your appreciation one more time. That was 10 fantastic rounds of boxing. And when you have a chance to box for the Lonsdale belt, that's the route you have to take. Congratulations to both boxers. So after 10 rounds of boxing for the British featherweight title eliminator, referee Paul Thomas has scored the contest for Chinnock, 95 points, for Williams, 96 points. Your winner from Hereford, Dazzo Williams.
He gets
and
it by one
show
round.
Your appreciation.
That's a surprise. Well done to both men.
Chinnock.